For a generation of West Africans, Ivory Coast was the region's economic dynamo, offering jobs and supplying electricity to the people of Mali, Benin, Ghana, Burkina Faso, and Togo. But years of political unrest and a brief civil war have left Ivorians uncertain about their future. In the last 10 years, per capita income has fallen 15%. Cocoa production is down. Abidjan's oil refinery has suspended production because of shrinking profit margins. Eddie Simon is Ivory Coast's director of power.
La puissance disponible est repartie aux consommateurs que nous sommes tous à partir d'un programme de délestage tournant.
Simon says the problem should be fixed by May, bringing sub-Saharan Africa's largest private sector power plant back online. But until then, the loss of power is cutting into the country's economy. Power cuts are common across most of Africa, but because Ivory Coast had such regular supplies of electricity for so long, few people own generators. That's a problem for fish merchant Salam Dumbia. Power cuts mean fewer people are going out at night, and that hurts business for bars and restaurants. When there's no power, restaurant owner Rosalie Amenendri says customers stay away. Taylor Dembois' Brew Nguesson also says power cuts are bad for business.
Dans le sens où je n'arrive plus à respecter mes rendez-vous. Et puis, ça devient comme un petit litige entre moi et ma clientèle. Au lieu de 4 jours, les rendez-vous, nous sommes obligés de doubler, soit 8 jours.
Demand for electricity in Ivory Coast is growing by about 10% each year. Energy officials say they plan to double generation by 2016 to meet greater local and regional appetites for power. Scott Stearns, VOA News, Dakar.